وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، أما بعد. وإن شرح في كتاب نواقض الإسلام written by شيخ الإسلام محمد بن عبد الوهاب رحمه الله تعالى. We were on the seventh naqid. We were talking about magic and matters pertaining to that. We mentioned four points regarding the seventh naqid. And inshallah ta'ala, today we're going to go into the fifth mas'ala pertaining to the issues of magic. Al-mas'alatul khamisa, the fifth mas'ala, the fifth matter. Is it possible that the magician, he can actually change something from method and being a human to a donkey? Can he actually do that? Can the magician actually do that? Or can he do the opposite? The response to this is, before I go into the answer, you have to first of all remember that the scholars, they all believe, the overwhelming majority of them, or a large amount of them believe, as we mentioned, that the magic is two types, right? There is a type which is known as magic which is haqiqi, it's a literal magic. And the magic that we said is haqiqi is the magic that affects the person. What does it do? It affects the person. It makes the person sick and ill. It can cause a person harm. It's a literal. And there's also magic which is takhayyul. The person sees things as it really isn't. So we spoke about that in details. But what is it that also the scholars unanimously agree upon? The scholars and the Muslims all unanimously agree upon that it's not sihr, that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does. The things that Allah does subhanahu wa ta'ala is not magic. What He does subhanahu wa ta'ala. مثلا when Allah tabarak wa ta'ala changed the stick of Nabiullah Musa and made it into a thuban, a big snake, we believe that this is not magic. We also, ihya al-mawta, giving life to the dead is also not magic. And etc. These are great signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah gave to messengers. These are miracles, we believe. These things, we can't say they can't change things, because they can. This is the qudra of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. This is what? The ability of Allah. What Allah did to the stick of Musa, na'am, it changed the stick. It was literally true. It happened. It's not takhayyul, what Musa did. That's what we believe. This is ijma'ul ummah. The ijma' of the Muslims. Are we all together? We're not talking about the things that Allah does. We're talking about magic and the magicians, what they do. Okay? Now that has become clear for us, the scholars differed amongst themselves. And the khulasa of this dispute, the summary of this khilaf, whether the magician can actually place, or he can change, sorry, the reality of something, is a mas'ala ahlul ilmi differed fima baynahum, amongst themselves. And the summary of this khilaf is brought by Hafidh ibn Hajar in Fathul Bari, the 10th volume, page 222. Hafiz ibn Hajar, he brings the khulasa of the khilaf, the summary and the conclusion of this dispute amongst the scholars. And he mentions that, he says, اختلفوا, the scholars differed في السحر in magic. هل يقع به انقلاب عين أو لا? They disputed whether the magic can change something from its essence, if it can change it. فَمَنْ قَالَ There are those scholars who said, إِنَّهُ تَخَيُّلُ That this is all what? تَخَيُّل. It's illusionary. That's it. And they didn't allow the fact that he can change it. وَمَنْ قَالَ إِنَّ لَهُ حَقِيقَةً Remember the scholars, what did we say? There were two types, right? So there were two types of magic, right? What was the first magic? Sihr al-takhayyul, right? Remember some of the scholars, they said the magic is, all of it is what? Takhayyul. There's no haqiqah to it. And we responded to them, right? Those ones, they don't have this issue, ishkal here. For them, it's going to be all what? It can't change anything. All of it is takhayyul. That's what they believe all magic is, right? Are we all together? The ones who believe that the magic is all illusionary, they're of course not going to have this issue here right now, which is, can the magic change the reality of something? Okay, they won't have that ishkal. That problem will not occur to them. Why would it not occur to them? Why would they not have that issue? The reason why they won't have it is because they believe every magic is takhayyul. Like in the ones who believe that the magic has haqiqah, has a reality to it, are we together? Other than it being illusionary, it can actually be a reality. They differed fima bainam amongst themselves. They are the ones who differed. From amongst them are those who said it can change it. And from amongst them are those who said it can't change it. So Hafidh ibn Hajar's kalam, it mentions that the dispute here is between those who said that the sihr is sihr al-haqiqi al-sihr, which is those who said that the inna lahu haqiqa, that magic has a reality to it. And when we said that the reality that we said that is in magic is what? That it affects the person. Sah? The affecting of the person is a reality. There's no lie about that. But they all believe that's all takhayyul, illusionary. It makes it seem that way. So what is right in this particular issue? I mean, what are the evidences of both parties? And what do they use? The ones who say that there's no reality, there's no changing something from another thing, they say that the fact that there's no evidence on the parties of those who say it does change something from method of being a human to a donkey. They've not brought anything that's happened like that. When Allah did speak about those who did do it, something like that, Allah referred to it as what? At-takhayyul. That Allah called it takhayyul. يُخَيَّلُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ سِحْرِمْ أَنَّهَا تَسْعَى. It looked like it to them. So عدم الدليل, the fact that the ones who said it can change its essence, so a human can be made into a donkey, they weren't able to provide any evidence. وَلِذَلِكَ Ibn al-Hajar, he strengthened that there is no way that it can change that. And he can do that. He refuted that. And also Sheikh Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen, he also refuses that that can happen or that can take place. وَلَذَلَكَ Sheikh ibn al-Uthaymeen rahimahullah, he actually, in his Qawl al-Mufid, which is the Sharh of Kitab al-Tawheed, he mentions that when he talks about تصديق الكاهن, trusting the fortune teller, he says that the trusting of the fortune teller from it is to believe that the magician's magic can actually change the reality and the essence of something. So it falls under that. That you actually believe the fortune teller or the magician when he tells you that he can change something from being something else, he said it falls under that. For example, if he says, I can make this wood into gold and you believe it. Or other than that, he says it falls under man saddaqa kahinan, anyone who believes in a kahin, a fortune teller. Because this is an ability only who has Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says Shaykh al-Uthaymeen. Also al-muhaqqiq al-imam, the great imam al-allama, Muhammad al-Amin al-Shanqiti in Adwa' al-Bayan, he also talks about this issue and he deals with it with a very scholastic approach. Rahimahullah, in his tafsir, Adwa' al-Bayan, he talks about it. Rahimahullah, when it came to the ayat in Surah Al-Baqarah, he talks about it. Al-mas'alatu al-sadisa, the sixth mas'ala. Hukmu ta'allamu al-sihr wal-amalu bihi. What is the ruling in learning magic and implementing magic? The scholars, they differed. Ikhtalafu ala thalatat aqwalin. Three views in this issue. The first view is, the person becomes a kafir by learning magic and doing magic. Whether he believes it's halal or whether he believes it's haram. Whatever he believes, it doesn't matter. He's a kafir for learning magic, and he's also a kafir for doing magic. This qawl is attributed to Abu Hanifa rahimahullah, Imam Malik and Ahmad rahimahullah, a riwayah of his, a riwayah of Imam Ahmad. And it is also narrated by Ali ibn Abi Talib radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. And this is the view that was strengthened by Ibn Qudama in his Mughni, Hafiz al-Hakami in his Ma'arij al-Qabul. Okay? Al-Imam al-Dhahabi in Kitab al-Kabair, he mentions that. ولذلك he says رحمه الله فترى خلقا كثيرا من الضلال يدخلون في السحر ويظنونه حراما فقط وما يشعرون أنه كفر. He mentions here الإمام الذهبي in his كتاب الكبائر that he says فترى خلقا, you see many creation, many of them, many misguided individuals that enter into magic and they believe it's haram. They only believe it's haram. And then look what he said after that. وَمَا يَشْعُرُونَ, but they don't know and they don't realize أَنَّهُ كُفْرٌ, that it's what? That it's disbelief. That it's what? That it's disbelief. وَلِذَلِكَ الْإِمَامِ مَالِكَ رَحِمَ اللَّهُ also said, إِنَّ تَعَلُّمَ السِّحْرِ, learning magic and teaching it is kufr. وَإِنْ لَمْ يَعْمَلْ بِهِ, even if the person doesn't implement the magic. Just by learning it and by teaching it, it's kufr. Even if the person doesn't implement it. And he mentions the reason why for that is because the person is honoring the shayateen and venerating the shayateen. And he said that لَا يَسْتَطِيعُ عَاقِلٌ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ أَنْ يَقُولَ فِيهِ إِنَّهُ لَيْسَ بِكُفْرٍ. And he went on to saying that he's not able, a person who's got rational mind, who believes in Allah, for him to say that this is not kufr. For him to say that this is not kufr. And the evidence that they use is the ayah وَاتَّبَعُوا مَا تَتْلُوا الشَّيَاطِينَ عَلَى مُلْكِ سُلَيْمَانَ وَمَا كَفَرَ سُلَيْمَانَ وَلَكِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ كَفَرُوا يُعَلِّمُونَ النَّاسَ سِحْرًا يُعَلِّمُونَ النَّاسَ سِحْرًا. They were teaching the people magic. They were what? They were teaching the people magic. And when they were teaching the people the magic, what would they say to them? إِنَّمَا نَحْنُ فِتْنَةٌ فَلَا تَكْفُرْ. We are a fitna from Allah, do not disbelief. So the teaching of the magic is of fitna and kufr. So do not become disbelievers. That's the adillah that they relied on. Hafiz al-Hakami mentions it greatly in his kitab Ma'arij al-Qabul. And also, so does al-Imam al-Allama Muhammad al-Amin Shanqiti rahimahullah. ولذلك al-Allama Muhammad al-Amin Shanqiti, when it came to the ayah, وَلَا يُفْلِحُ السَّاحِرُ حَيْثُ أَتَى, he says that, وَلَا يُفْلِحُ, he says, عُرِفًا بِاسْتِقْرَاءِ الْقُرْآنِ, it is known by following up the Quran. And غالبا, that the majority of the usage of the word لا يفلح يراد بها الكافر is intended by the disbeliever. كقوله تعالى, like the statement of Allah in Surah Yunus, قالوا اتخذ الله ولدا هو الغني له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض إن عندكم من سلطان بهذا أتقولوا على الله ما لا تعلمون قل إن الذين قل إن الذين يفترون على الله الكذب لا يفلحون متاع في الدنيا ثم إلينا مرجعهم ثم نذيقهم العذاب الشديد بما كانوا يكفرون. So Allah says here, قل إن الذين يفترون على الله الكذب لا يفلحون. So لا يفلحون here is means the kuffar. Also Allah says سبحانه وتعالى in Surah Yunus as well, فَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ افْتَرَى عَلَى اللَّهِ كَذِبًا أَوْ كَذَّبَ بِآيَاتِ إِنَّهُ لَا يُفْلِحُ الْمُجْرِمُونَ. Surah Yunus, ayah 17. Also Surah Al-An'am, what does Allah say? وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ افْتَرَى عَلَى اللَّهِ كَذِبًا أَوْ كَذَّبَ بِآيَاتِ إِنَّهُ لَا يُفْلِحُ الظَّالِمُونَ. In Surah Al-An'am, ayah 21. So Muhammad Amin al-Shaqiti says, and other than those verses, all of them, when Allah uses the word لَا يُفْلِح, he's talking about the kuffar. Then this ayah, which is وَلَا يُفْلِحُ السَّاحِرُ, the magician will not be successful. He is talking about the kafir. لَا يُفْلِحُ أَيْدَ الْكَافِر, will not be successful. حَيْثُ أَتَى, wherever he comes from. And as you all know, the word حَيْثُ كَلِمَة is تَدُلُّ عَلَى الْمَكَانِ, whereas حِينَ is تَدُلُّ عَلَى الزَّمَانِ, right? So the magician, wherever he comes from, okay, he's not going to find success. And Allah Ta'ala, he left the ayah, وَلَا يُفْلِحُ السَّاحِرُ حَيْثُ أَتَى, The word حيث is أسلوب العربي المعروف. It's a usage that the Arabs use, which is meant by a ta'meem, that it's generalization, to just leave it open. حيث, wherever it may be. So whether it be studying magic, or learning magic, or teaching magic, or doing magic, it encompasses all of that. That's what Al-Allama Muhammad Al-Shanqiti, rahimahullah, Muhammad Amin Al-Shanqiti mentions. Before him, Shaykh Al-Islam Taymiyyah said that in the 29th volume, page 384-385. He brought those verses before. Also from the scholars that took that opinion is also Al-Imam Al-Bukhari, rahimahullah. He done a chapter in his Sahih, where he chapter Babu Sihri, the chapter of magic, and then he mentions the ayat that we mentioned from Surah Al-Baqarah, وَاتَّبِعُ مَا تَتْلُوا الشَّيَاطِينَ عَلَى مُلْكِ سُلَيْمَانِ. And Hafidh al-Hajar mentions that the reason why the author brought these verses is that he chose the ruling of kufr on the magicians. Okay? And if you look at the siyaq of the ayat, what does Allah say after that? وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ آمَنُوا وَاتَّقَوْا. When the ayah finishes, Allah says, وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ آمَنُوا, if they were to believe in Allah, and they were to what? Have taqwa. Meaning they didn't believe in Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. They what? They didn't believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, many of the salafu hadhi al-ummah, like the companions, they all believe that the magician should be killed. Okay? The magician should be what? He should be killed. And the scholars who believe, sahabas who believe that was Umar radiallahu anhu, Umar ibn Khattab, Uthman ibn Affan, Hafsa bint Umar, Abdullah ibn Umar, Jundub ibn Abdullah radiallahu ta'ala anhum, and others. And so the scholars of this view, they said, if the killing of the magician is permitted, the Prophet already told us, لا يحل دم امرئ مسلم إلا بإحدى ثلاثة. الثيب الزاني والنفس بالنفس وتارك لدينه المفارق للجماعة. That the blood of a believer is not allowed to be spilt except in one of three situations. Either that he is an individual who is what? A thayyib zani, he has committed adultery. He has committed zina outside marriage. Wa nafsu bin nafsi, he has killed another person. Or the third one, which is وَتَارِكُ لِدِينِهَا الْمُفَارِقُ لِلْجَمَاعَةِ. And the scholars, they said that it only is the third one. Because this person is still alive, he hasn't killed him. Nor has he also committed zina. So the only one it is وَتَارِكُ لِدِينِهَا الْمُفَارِقُ لِلْجَمَاعَةِ. And the hadith is found by, narrated by Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim, min hadith Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So this shows us what? That the magician is a disbeliever. The second view is, anna sahira la yakfur, that the magician is not a kafir, bita'allum al-sihri wal-amalu bihi. That he is not a kafir by learning magic and by implementing magic. He doesn't become a kafir. And this view is transmitted from Imam Ahmad, the riwayah of Hanbal. And Ibn Qudama brings it in his kitab Al-Mughni, which is a sharh mukhtasar al-khiraqi. He brings it, and after he brings the qawl of Imam Ahmad, he says, وَهَذَا يَدُلُّ عَلَىٰ أَنَّهُ لَمْ يَكْفُرُ. And this is an indication that Ahmad لَمْ يُكَفِّرْهُ. Ahmad, he did not place takfir on them. لِأَنَّهُ لَوْ كَفَّرَهُ لَقَتَلَهُ وَقَوْلُهُ فِي مَعْنَى الْمُرْتَدِ يعني فِي الْاِسْتِتَابَةِ. Ahmed saw that they shouldn't be killed. And Ibn Qudama is saying that if Ahmed did see it to be kuffar, he would have said, kill them. Also, the scholars that pushed that opinion is Al-Imam Ibn Hazm al-Rahimahullah in his Muhalla. There's a very lengthy statement, Ibn Hazm. Look at his kitab al-Muhalla. If you get the 13th volume of the book, page 469-480. To all of that, Ibn Hazm is talking about it. That's over 10 pages, taqriban, sah? He talks about it. Very good. And he strengthened that it's not kufr akbar. And the strongest evidence that they use is the story of Aisha radiallahu anha that Bayhaqi narrated, Ibn Hazm narrated in his Muhalla, Ahmad narrated in his Musnad, that Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she freed a magician. She freed. Who did magic, or who's a magician. She freed her, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. So what they said was, look, this is an evidence for us. And this, also Abdul Razak narrated it, and Imam Malik narrated it, and Sheikh Nasir authenticated in his Irwa'il Ghalil. The third opinion. The third opinion is the view that was taken by Imam Shafi'i, and the majority of his madhab, the Aimatu Madhab Shafi'iyah. And it's a qawl by the Ahnaf, and it's a view strengthened by Qarafi min al Malikiyah in his Kitab al Furuq, Hafid al Hakami in his Kitab I'lam al Sunnah al Mashura, al Shanqiti in his Adwa al Bayan, al Razihi in his Tafsir, Nawawi and Hafid in Fath al Bari, Ibn Uthaymeen al Bardawi in his Kitab al Insaf, and it's the qawl of the Jamahir al Hanabila and the Jama'at min al Malikiyah, which is the qawl which is sahih, inshallah. And that is, النساحر, إن كان سحره, if the magician's magic is through the shayateen and is through statements and actions of kufr, فهو كافر, he's a disbeliever. وإن كان سحره, but if he does the magic عبر الأدوية والتداخين, he does it through smokes and he does other ways that he does it, medication, whatever he uses, he does it through other ways, he doesn't involve magicians or whatnot, لا يكفر, he doesn't become a kafir. He becomes a kafir if he does it all abra shayateen. But if he does it through other means, he's not a kufr. This adilla, the adilla of this qawl is the fact that there are evidences on both sides. So we have, for example, the story of Aisha that the second party mentioned, that the magician that Aisha freed was based on what? That this magic was through, it was other than Abra al-Shayateen. That's why Aisha freed them. Okay? That is why Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she freed the magician. The evidence is to show that if it's done through the Shayateen, is what? The statement of Allah, وَاتَّبَعُوا مَا تَتْلُوا الشَّيَاطِينَ عَلَى مُلْكِ سُلَيْمَانَ وَمَا كَفَرَ سُلَيْمَانَ وَلَكِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ كَفَرُوا يُعَلِّمُونَ النَّاسَ السِّحْرَ. That's jam' بين الأدلة. That's bringing the evidences together, and that is a way to what? Work on it. Al-Imam al-Shafi'i spoke about this issue in depth in his Kitab al-Umm, the first volume, page 294. Also Al-Ifsah Ibn Huwayra, he talks about it in the second volume, 226. Ibn Kathir rahimahullah, he talks about it in the first volume, Surah Baqarah, when he comes to وَاتَّبَعُوا مَا تَتْلُوا الشَّيَاطِينَ عَلَى مُلْكِ سُلَيْمَانَ. First volume, page 131. Ibn Qudama, the ninth volume, page 35. Al-Mardawi in his Kitab al-Insaf, the 10th volume, page 301. And he does tafsir of the mas'ala. Hafidh al-Hajar in Fath al-Bari, the 11th volume, 224. And Imam al-Nawawi, the 14th volume, page 176. And Amin al-Shanqiti, he brings it in the 4th volume, is Adwa al-Bayan, 456. And he brings a tahqiq on this mas'ala. He says, التحقيق في هذه المسألة هو التفصيل. Muhammad al-Amin al-Shanqiti says, as for this issue, the correct way is التفصيل. What does التفصيل mean? التفصيل means that you break the matter down. فإن كان السحر مما يعظم فيه غير الله. If the magic is done in venerating, glorifying other than Allah, like, for example, the stars and the galaxies, the jinn, and other than that, مما يؤدي إلى الكفر, that which will need to what? كفر. فهو كفر بلا نزاع. Then this is كفر without argument. And this he said, وهذا النوع من السحر, ومن هذا النوع السحر, هاروت وماروت. هاروت and ماروت, السحر is from this type, which was what? كواكب and jinn الشياطين. Which is mentioned in Surah Al-Baqarah, فَإِنَّ كُفْرٌ بِلَا نِزَاعٍ. This one is kufr without argument. وَإِنْ كَانَ السِّحْرُ, but if the magic, لَا يَقْتَضِي الْكُفْرُ كَالِاسْتِعَانَةِ بِخَوَاصِ بَعْضِ الْأَشْيَاءِ مِنْ. If this kufr, this magic, is not done in the aid, asking for the help and the support of shayateen and whatnot, it's not. It's actually done through what? Other means. فهو حرام حرمة شديدة. This is haram, excessively haram. ولكنه لا يبلغ بصاحبه, but this will not reach the individual. الكفر كفر. وهذا هو التحقيق. This is the تحقيق of the قول. This is how to really settle the matter. إن شاء الله, he says. في هذه المسألة التي اختلف فيها العلماء. In this matter which the scholars differed upon. Hafiz ibn Hajar pushes that as well. Even Sulaiman ibn Abdullah ibn Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, the author of the Tafsir Aziz al-Hamid, he also talks about it in page 384 that the magic should be broken into those two. Going back to the statement of Shaykh al-Islam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab rahimahullah, he says, وَمِنْهُ from it is, if you go back to the matter, he says, وَمِنْهُ الصَّرْفُ وَالْعَطْفُ. And from the magic is what? الصرف. What does الصرف actually means? الصرف means to divert the man from his spouse, the wife, or the wife from her husband. It's actually to what? أن ينصرف الإنسان عن زوجته. The person, he has no desire for his spouse anymore, his partner. Other than that, he doesn't have love for her anymore. That dies. The matter becomes enmity and hate towards each other. Argumentations and disputes. And atf is the opposite. Atf is actually to what? To love your spouse. So somebody will do magic to make two people love each other. To bring them together. The man would love his wife excessively, or the wife would love her husband excessively. Until the person becomes in the person's submission like the animal. Like that. The person can actually control this individual as he wishes. Muhammad ibn Abdullah said, فَمَنْ فَعَالَهُ أَوْ رَضِيَ بِهِ. Anyone who does this or is pleased with this, kafara, he becomes a disbeliever. As for the person who does sihr, we already spoke about it. Sahih? We already spoke about this mas'ala and what it means. What about the issue of مَنْ رَضِيَ بِهِ? The one who is pleased with it. بِأَنَّهُ كَافِرٌ that he's a kafir. That's correct. And who is pleased with it, then he's a kafir. لَأَنَّ السِّحْرَ كُفْرٌ Because sihr is what? Magic. وَالْرِضَى بِالْكُفْرِ كُفْرٌ And to be pleased with disbelief is disbelief. But that is if the magic is through the shayateen. And that's the author's view here. That's what he's trying to say. Are we together? If the person is pleased with the type which is kufr akbar, where the person leaves the religion and is pleased with that one, then الرضا بالكفر كفر. To be pleased with kufr is kufr. صح? But if the person is pleased with the other one, then he doesn't reach kufr. He doesn't what? He doesn't reach kufr. ولذلك the evidence for that is Allah says in the Quran, وَقَدْ نَزَّلَ عَلَيْكُمْ فِي الْكِتَابِ أَنْ إِذَا سَمِعْتُمْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ يُكْفَرُ بِهَا وَيُسْتَهْزَأُ بِهَا فَلَا تَقْعُدُوا مَعَهُمْ حَتَّى يَخُوضُوا فِي حَدِيثٍ غَيْرِ إِنَّكُمْ إِذَا مِثْلُهُمْ. This ayah Allah tells us, وَقَدْ نَزَّلْ عَلَيْكُمْ فِي الْكِتَابِ has been sent down onto you on the Qur'an, that if you hear the verses of Allah being disbelieved on and mocked, then don't sit with people who are doing that until they go into a speech and things other than the kufr that they're saying. If you do sit with them and you carry sitting on with them, إِنَّكُمْ إِذَا مِثْلُهُمْ then you are truly like them. Al-Imam al-Qurtubi said in the tafsir of this ayah, he said, فَدَلَّ بِهَذَا this ayah has indicated عَلَى وُجُوبِ that is obligatory اجتناب أصحاب المعاصي that you stay away from the people of sins إذا ظهر منهم منكر if evil comes from them لأن من لم يجتنبهم because the one who doesn't stay away from them فقد رضي فعلهم then he's pleased with their action والرضا بالكفر كفر being pleased with disbelief is disbelief because that's why Allah said إنكم إذا مثلهم what they're doing is كفر and you're here sitting with them enjoying it not leaving it. This is an indication that you're pleased with it. And now that you're pleased with it, then you're what? You're pleased with kufr. And to be pleased with kufr is kufr. أي إن الرضا بالمعصية معصية. Because he says, as for being pleased with sins, it's a sin. ولهذا يؤاخذ الفاعل والراضي بعقوبة المعاصي حتى يهلكوا بأجمعهم. That the one who does the kufr and the one who is pleased with the kufr, both of them are punished. And the one who is pleased with the sin and the one who does the sin are both punished. Allah, until he destroys them all. So this ayah is an indication and an evidence for that statement of the Shaykh, which is, فَمَنْ فَعَالَهُ أَوْ رَضِيَ بِهِ anyone who is happy and pleased with kufr is a kafir. And anybody who is happy with sin is a sinner. What was it that was upon you? That if you hear somebody indulging into this, stay, go, get away from it. Because can you be in a place where you don't like and you're not pleased with? Shouldn't. A person wouldn't be in a place they don't like. Okay? If this room's temperature gets very, 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 very cold, and it becomes freezing cold, would you stay in the room? You'd go to another room that's hot, the temperature's good. Sah. So why would you stay in a place where you know the disbelief of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala has been spoken? You wouldn't be able to sit there. That's why this ayah, the scholars used it with sitting with innovators. The person shouldn't sit with the innovators. If you sit with the innovators, then that's an indication that you're pleased with their innovation. And if you're pleased with their innovation, الرِّضَى بِالْبِدْعَةِ بِدْعَةٌ. To be pleased with innovation is an innovation itself. You become an innovator based on that. You become an innovator based on that. We'll stop there inshaAllah ta'ala for this naqidh. We're going to go into the 8th naqidh, it's a very long naqidh. It talks about mas'alatul muwalat. And we'll speak about that very lengthy inshaAllah ta'ala, as it's one of the masail that the discussions have become excessive on it. We'll leave that for next lesson inshaAllah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.